Rant Session, Episode 27, Nintendo's 2020, My Experience. Go. With a new year comes new gaming experiences, and in 2020, many people would say that their experiences were Cyberpunk 2077, Call of Duty Cold War, Animal Crossing New Horizons, or the Final Fantasy VII Remake. Now, I did play one of these games. Can you tell which one? I have always mainly been a Nintendo fan, and this year was no exception. I played many Switch titles this year, and I'm going to be giving mini reviews to each of them. Quick disclaimer, not all of these games actually released in the past year. These are just the ones that I played. Oh, and also, I'm only going to be talking about games that I played for the first time in the past year. I mean, what, did you expect me to say, guys, I played Minecraft this year, huh? No kidding. My list of games that I played in the past year includes Paper Mario the Origami King, Rhyme, Super Mario 3D All-Stars, Abzu, Ori and the Blind Forest, Animal Crossing New Horizons, and Dragon Quest XI. Now, not all of these are Nintendo titles, but they were all played on the Nintendo Switch, so without further ado, let's begin. Paper Mario the Origami King is a game that I thoroughly enjoyed. I'm a firm believer that Nintendo needs to bring the series back to its roots, but you can't deny that it's still super enjoyable. The battle system is very poorly designed, and the story leaves a lot to be desired, but I would be lying if I said that this game was not super fun to play through. And the music is top-notch. Nintendo could make a game where all you do is stare at a wall and the music would be incredible. Abzu is a game I've been wanting to play for a long time, and I finally played it a few months ago, and I can say it's exactly what I wanted it to be. There's no clear objective, I don't even think there's anything in the game that can actually harm you, but this game is so great to just turn the lights off and play for a long time. The game is absolutely beautiful with deep, endless underwater caverns to explore and colorful environments to swim through. The game is so chilled and so easy to sit down and play for an indefinite amount of time. Super Mario 3D All-Stars. How am I supposed to review this one? It's a compilation of Super Mario 64, Super Mario Sunshine, and Super Mario Galaxy to commemorate the 35th anniversary of Mario. That's two of the greatest games of all time and Super Mario Sunshine. So why do people have problems with this game? This game is $60 and adds zero extra content other than the soundtracks and upping the resolution. I'm actually okay with this being priced as a new game. It adds up to each game being $20 each, so I think it works. But what I don't understand is how Nintendo barely did anything for the 35th anniversary of Mario. This franchise is the most important gaming franchise in history, and so many people would love to see some cool behind-the-scenes footage from the games, but instead they just threw the games together into a collection with no care put into it. This is not how you treat the anniversary of Mario. But I don't have room to speak because I bought it. The games are absolutely incredible, but as a compilation and anniversary, it flops hard. Ori and the Blind Forest, oh, so incredible. This is one of the most satisfying games I've played. The movement is spot on and the game looks and sounds amazing. As a fan of 2D platformers, I knew I was going to love it, but I was not in store for how spot on of an experience it would be. The game can be tough as nails, but with how satisfying it is to pull off hard jumps and tricks, the toughest parts that make you want to throw your controller can be a blast. This is certainly my favorite game of them all. Animal Crossing New Horizons. Now, this is easily the biggest of them all. You couldn't go on Twitter for like 3 months without seeing this game. Well, what did I think about it? I really enjoyed it, but it's not the same enjoyment I got out of any other Animal Crossing game. The way it shakes up the series formula is substantial, and even as a big fan of the game, I can still tell something's missing. That Animal Crossing magic is just not quite there with this one. I think the game is very enjoyable, but with features like terraforming and being able to place anything anywhere, it borders on feeling overwhelming. New Horizons is a top-notch Nintendo title that makes you miss the old Animal Crossing games. Rhyme. This game's not that good. It looks bad and runs terribly, so much to where the game almost feels incomplete. There's a lot of interesting and fun puzzles in the game, and it has a lot of potential, but the way it runs just makes it such a drag. I would be interested in a remaster where the game truly feels like everything it was cut out to be from the beginning. But as it currently stands, this is my least favorite game I played. And finally, Dragon Quest XI S, Echoes of an Elusive Age Definitive Edition. It's pretty good. So that concludes my year in gaming. Now you may say, Lawson, it's May. Why are you just now talking about this? I was preoccupied. Although I'm very late to the party, I can't wait to see what this next year has in store for gaming. Rant session over.